Hello, my name is Frederick Douglass, and this is my life.
When I was a young man, I was a slave. It was not fun. Oh, in Baltimore, when I was working for the Auld family? Yes, it was the Auld family. A nice woman taught me how to read and write, actually. She did not know that it was illegal to teach a colored man to read and write. And, also Baltimore is where I met my wife. Foxy lady right there.
While in Baltimore, Frederick Douglass worked in a shipyard to earn extra money for his slave master. Frederick despised the life of a slave. He decided he wanted out.
And that's when I escaped. Did you try any of this?
So, in September 1838, Frederick Douglass took a train to New York using fake slave papers. It may have been a relatively calm transition, but to Frederick, he was running for his life.
Shortly thereafter, I started attending abolitionist meetings, where they were happy to see a runaway slave speaking his mind. At those meetings, I made my goals clear and specific. I told them that in order for society to function correctly, we would have to have equality for every human being, no matter whether he's colored, white, male, female. It doesn't matter. Have you been to urbanprofile.com?
I have not.
Look, they have t-shirts of me. Here, can you zoom in on this? They have Frederick Douglass t-shirts, small and black. There's also, we have it in red. Oh, look at that stash.
Hi, my name is Frederick Douglass, and
thereafter, Frederick Douglass started attending various abolitionist meetings, speaking at almost all of them.
Well,
he was a brilliant orator. Very quickly, his voice fell on many ears.
Is bad.
Eventually, he started publishing the North Star.
Ta-da!
The North Star.
My story was so compelling that millions read my autobiography. My impact on the abolitionist movement today was immense, as we know it. In fact, Abe Lincoln himself gave me one of his favorite walking movies. And actually, he was the one behind the camera doing the biography in it.
That's right.
Success? Yes, I would say that I had quite a bit of success. I enlisted blacks into the army during the Civil War, which previously, as Abe Lincoln can tell you, that was illegal until I started and changed his mind. And unfortunately, after the Civil War, even though the fight had been won, blacks were still bound to their masters because they didn't have the financial ability to just go it on their own. So they still did paid work for their masters, although it wasn't very much that they got paid.
And thus the fight continued.
After my wife died, I married a woman named Helen Pitts. Then I focused my attention more towards women's rights.
Frederick Douglass even attended the Seneca Falls Convention.
The reason I did this biography was because Frederick Douglass was just such a great man. Without him, my presidency would have been lackluster, I suppose. He really convinced me to fight for slave rights and thus change the history of the United States.
This has been an Abe Lincoln biography.
Hi, I'm Frederick Douglass.
How you going?
Mm-hmm.
Dan